Ready? So today's episode is going to be about you and how we have you on board. You cool with that?
Yeah.
Yeah? You want to show people how we have you on board and how we sail with you?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. If you enjoy this video, consider clicking the subscribe button and follow our adventures sailing around the world. Hi, we're the James family.
Are you sick of your day-to-day life? Ever thought about doing something different?
Well, we did just that.
We bought an unfinished aluminium catamaran and we're fixing her up as we sail around the world.
Come along for the journey and click subscribe.
Daddy? Mommy? Charlie?
We are a family of three living full-time on board our sailboat, sailing around the world. In 2022, we sold our house and haven't looked back. Today, we are sharing how we sail and live full-time on board our boat with our two-year-old daughter, Charlie. We moved on board when Charlie was 16 months old, and today we are sharing what we use and do, from safety items to gear, to sleeping arrangements and potty training, and how we survive and sail with a two-year-old.
Hey, Charlie, girl.
Hello.
Hey, Charlie.
Right in there? Yeah. So we get lots of questions, from sleeping to laundry to safety gear and how we have her on board and what we do. So we thought, why not answer them in a video? So we have a whole bunch of questions here in the hat of common ones that we get. So to get started, do you want to pull the first question?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Cool. So pick one. That one?
Yeah.
Toilet and shower. How do you use the facilities on board?
Over here.
Where is the shower and toilet? Do you want to show everyone?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's go show everyone the shower and toilet.
Shower and toilet.
Oh, where is it?
Here.
Down there.
So in the sun and in the toilet. The shower here.
So the toilet is a common question that we get for Charlie and how we are toilet training or what we do on board with a little human and using the toilet and the shower. Do we have a bathtub? Do we bathe? Does she shower? There's all sorts of questions. So let's tackle them right now. So we'll go this way. This is the bathroom. We've got the normal toilet here, and then swoop around into the shower, we've got Charlie's little training toilet here. So right now she's going in between the two. She likes to use the big kid toilet, but then she also does still use this one. And that is how we're toilet training. It's just sitting in the shower. It's easy cleanup. If there's any misses or messes, everything's easy. For bathing, for showers and baths, Charlie takes a shower. So we've got this one here. We do have a bit of a lip down here. We can fill this to about here with water and use it as a bathtub. But Charlie just showers, and she just takes a shower with either Sam or myself.
Hey, well done.
What is this? Where does Charlie sleep? Where does Charlie sleep?
Okay, come with me. Come with me.
Okay, we'll come with you.
You come with me?
Yep.
Right here.
You sleep there.
I sleep. This is your toilet?
Yep, that's the toilet.
This is your shower?
Yep, and that's the shower.
This is yours?
Yep. And this is yours.
Yeah. Where's my bed?
Where's your bed?
Where's your hand?
Do you want to hop in your bed?
No. I can't sleep.
You won't be going to sleep. You'll be. Do you want to show everyone how you climb up into bed?
I can't climb a bed. It's coming. Oh no, it's raining.
Yeah, it's raining. So this is Charlie's room. So she's got a net here on the side of her bed. And the top part is a bungee. And the bungee is attached to the wall over there, as well as the wall over here. And then it's child netted. And the child net is attached. So it's screwed into the bottom. So it's hard screwed in. And then the bungee allows her to push it down to climb out and go down the stairs. And the net is tight enough that if she was to roll, it will catch her and stop her from rolling out of bed.
I've got Heidi. Follow me.
Can you pick another one?
Okay. I'm gonna pick this one.
What does it say? Laundry.
Show you.
Where's the laundry?
Show you laundry. Right there.
Right there?
Yes.
So the laundry is currently going at the moment, but we do have a washing machine on board. So we're really lucky that we have the space for it. It took us a while to find a washing machine that would fit this space. So this is like a normal washing machine, it's just a lot thinner. It's only 400 millimeters thick, or deep, I guess I should say. And this was one of my requirements on board. And with a toddler, we go through how many sets of clothes a day? Like 3 or 4 sets of clothes a day. Just muddy and stuff and play clothes. So this has been an absolute lifesaver on board, because if we didn't have this, we would be hand washing all the clothes.
Is this Tiggy's jacket?
That is Tiggy's jacket. Can you choose another one?
I choose this one.
That's 3. Can I have one of them?
Yeah.
Let's do this one. Furniture.
She's in the Tiggy.
So furniture. How do we have furniture on board with a toddler? That's a very good question. How do we keep it clean? Well, we recently redid the upholstery inside. All this gray is the new color. And you can probably tell that we are sitting on a cover. So, the grey didn't last too long. We found that it started showing dirt really fast. So we've taken old fitted sheets and tailored them to the couch. And this is our way of having a cover that is easy to take off and put through the washing machine and easy to clean. Because we were finding that the grey was getting really dirty really fast and was showing lots of wear. We also have the dining room table covered. The table is a wood table, and when we moved on board, we noticed that we were getting marks in the table really easily from toys, crayons, colored pencils, and it was just showing marks really easily. So to protect it, we got one of these thick, clear plastic tablecloths and put it on there. So that's how we do that with the furniture on board, isn't it?
Where's yours here?
Can I see it?
Yeah. Sure.
Safety and boundaries for Charlie.
Oh, good.
So safety and boundaries for Charlie. We have this entire boat child netted. So all along the sides of the boat, this is all child netted. The forward area across the bow is off child netted, and all down that side. The other thing we have on board is gates for the sugar scoops. So we've got these ones here, and they just open, close, and lock. The second one is the sailing harness that we have. It's a Burke sailing harness that goes around Charlie's body in between the legs, and on the back of it there's a tether, and there's a hook on it, so you can hook her in while we're sailing and everything. What else do we have for you on board? We've got your life jacket.
Yeah, here's my jacket.
Where's your life jacket?
I don't know.
Twirl, 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 twirl. So Charlie's life jacket has the hood on the neck like this. Can you turn around? We also have gone for one with a handle on the back, which is really useful for grabbing them if they're going to do something, go anywhere they're not supposed to, or accidentally step off the wharf or into the water. It's got the crotch area that goes right in between the legs and everything. There's a whistle back here hidden underneath the headpiece to stay out of the sun. So one of the other things that we installed on this boat is a lock for the main door. So up here at the top, we've got a barn lock, and it locks like that. That way it's all the way up there. Charlie can't reach it, and if she ever was to get out while we are all sleeping, she can't open the door and get out. The reason we put the lock at the top here was because we were worried when Charlie started to walk and go into her own bed, was if we're sleeping at night and Sam and I are in the bed and Charlie's in her bed, we actually don't have a clue if she gets up during the middle of the night and she could go out on deck. The other thing is, once you lock this door, you can still open and go out. So this lock is just for the outside. So we wanted something that we could lock that she can't physically get out. The hatches, she is way too short to reach the hatches. And the two forward hatches are locked. So once we're all sleeping, there's no way that she can get out of the boat without us knowing. So that was one of our biggest fears, was what if she what if she walks at night, sleepwalks? We don't know. We know the boat is child netted, but what if something happens? And this is just an added security for us. So this is to make us feel better, and it's just an added security. This one, meals, and where does Charlie eat? Where do you eat normally? You eat outside.
I eat you.
So with meals, Charlie normally eats outside. So she eats out on the back deck. And this is normally Charlie's spot. So this is her seat, and this is where she normally eats. So where do you eat?
I eat.
You eat right there.
I'm hungry.
So this is normally where Charlie eats. So for breakfast and lunch, for most meals she eats out here. It's just such an easy cleanup. You could just take out the hose from the deck wash and just hose everything down, take a bucket, and we've got the drains there, two big ones on the back over there and over there. Super easy peasy for a cleanup. For dinner we normally have inside all together on the couch, and Charlie's spot to eat is this one here where it's covered.
Thank you so much for watching. If you are enjoying our videos and would like to help support us making videos and content, consider becoming a Patreon. The link is in the description below. And don't forget to click those like and subscribe buttons, and we will see you all next week.